Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'd like to review the sequence of events leading up to July 11th, when the portal went down, the MedRight portal. And just so I'm clear on the timeline, in early June, the Department of Health and the Office of Technology and Innovation met, and the decision was made to use the Vax4NYC portal that had been used for COVID-19. But that wasn't going to be ready for some time, so the decision was made in the interim to continue using MedRight. Is that correct?
Specific timing on June 29th, the decision was made to incorporate the functionality into Vax4NYC, and that's when the build started. The projected timing was expected to take 3 weeks, which would take us into the week of the 20th of July. We actually delivered a week early, and the functionality went live the evening of July 14th.
Thank you. And were there any concerns raised that the MedRight site might not be able to accommodate the volume of people seeking vaccine appointments?
As Dr. Easterling pointed out, MedRight and AP, the teams that they had partnered with to do this, were teams that had done similar work across the city historically to do this kind of thing. Given previous performance, decisions were made to use them again. And if the city had seen something like this similar to what we saw, then other decisions would have been made.
Were there any events in the past with MedRight that were similar to what this was, where you had thousands, so many people at an appointed hour accessing the site at the same time?
Is that specific to this administration, or are you asking the previous administration?
Yeah, the Department of Health. I mean, what prior experience had happened with MedRight that might have led the department to think that this would work?
As Dr. Easterling has stated, and he can go through the levels of service that MedRight is still actively performing, although this is one failed instance, they've been a partner to the city in many other ways. And if you want to go into the details behind the where they're also providing service.
Yeah, that's absolutely right, Commissioner, and thank you for the question, Councilmember. MedRight is a contracted vendor that we've been using since 2021 in a number of different settings, our in-home vaccinations, and so really getting our COVID-19 vaccine out to our elderly, supporting our school vaccination program, other congregate settings like long-term care facilities, really working with this vendor. And so, really these are contained populations and making sure that they're getting the vaccines out. Again, this isn't a vendor that really focuses on scheduling capabilities. And so this is something that we did ask them to do, particularly for this rollout.
Do you think that anyone at MedRight should have potentially have flagged that their own site might not be up to this? How many appointments were offered on July 11th? Like 1,200? It wasn't many.
Right. I think we had about 1,000 doses.
Yeah, and tens of thousands of people potentially trying to access the site. Do you think anyone at MedRight should have said, "Hey, maybe this is going to be a concern"? And did they know that this many people might potentially be accessing the site at that precise moment?
Well, I cannot speak for any individual at MedRight. What I can say is that in working with the vendors, there were a number of different things that we did to assess user experience, such as accessibility, user testing as well. Certainly, we didn't explore surge testing, and so we've learned from our errors. We certainly want to continue to improve upon and make sure that we get this right for New Yorkers, and I think that's the focus.
And I think, I want you to know that when I ask these questions, it's because I represent a district where many thousands of people did have a very bad experience that day. And it's more than just not being able to get a vaccine that day. It really erodes trust in the whole system. And for many people, this is their first experience interacting with the city or even seeking this kind of health care. So I think we all acknowledge that it was a very regrettable incident and we're moving forward, but I really want to make sure that we learn every possible lesson that can be learned to make sure that this never happens again. And based on what I've heard today, I think that a lot of lessons have been learned, and I'm pretty confident that the department going forward is gonna avoid this in the future. Last question. On the MedRight site, and you should check this out for the future, and then maybe this has been raised to you. When you're making an appointment, you select an available appointment and you're entering all your info. By the time you're done entering your info, that appointment could be gone. That doesn't happen with Vax for NYC. It doesn't happen with Ticketmaster. Is Ticketmaster still around? Why is that the case, and can that be fixed for anyone who uses MedRight in the future?
When it comes to the capabilities of MedRight's portal and the way the technology works, we will look at them in the areas where they provide services for the city to ensure that that functionality has parity with the other services that our people within New York City currently experience. So we will take that back and look at any areas where we're leveraging MedRight for vaccine distribution to ensure parity.
Thank you.
Yep. And Council Member, I do want to just go on record and acknowledge, and I thank you for raising it. We have learned from our mistakes, and we are committed to doing better going forward.